my urban life friends, those of you who love all things urban, city, sophistication, coolness, everything like that. Anyway, I truly love the country too, because so do I. I love them both. And that's the beauty of being alive, is that I love all kinds of different things. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you how to make a roast chicken. Now last week I roasted a beautiful chicken, and I posted it on Facebook no less. And seemed like everybody loved it. And so I thought, well, why not cut a video of me making this roast chicken and show you all how it's done. And so that's what I'm gonna do, and we're gonna get right to it. So, and meanwhile, I'm gonna have my ubiquitous glass of wine. Tonight I'm having a little Spanish Roja. It's a Tempranillo, it's really delicious. But that's not what I'm gonna serve with the chicken, so. Don't worry, although it does taste good with chicken. But let's get started, take you on a wonderful journey, and I'm gonna show you how to make the most delicious roast chicken you have ever had in your entire life. Okay, now the first step in this process is to, I use an organic chicken. So, you know, I prefer organic. I like the way they're treated better, you know, they're more humane and they're a lot fresher, like free range chicken. Now the first thing you wanna do is you wanna get the chicken room temperature. And you don't have to be religious about this, but you know, I like my chicken to, you know, warm up a little bit. And then I like hot chicks. What am I supposed to say? So anyway, so then what you do is, you know, you take the insides out and everything, and you wash the chicken down, rinse it off, and pat dry it. And then you want to liberally salt it inside and out. And you can see how much salt I'm putting on this. Now, I use ground sea salt, so you can see there's a lot of salt, because the reason is the salt seasons the chicken inside and out, and it really imparts a magnificent flavor. So what you want to do is you just want to salt that. Now I'm going to let that sit for a little while and let the salt just kind of simmer in there, and then I'll get back with you and show you the next step. One thing I forgot to mention before I salted the chicken is that you pour olive oil on it. I use extra virgin olive oil, and I pour a lot on, and then so then I roll the chicken around in the olive oil so it's totally coated with olive oil, and it imparts a great flavor, and it's part of the process, and you do that before you salt it, of course. All right, faithful followers, while we're waiting for the chicken to marinate in the salt, and while we're waiting for my oven to preheat at 425, I'm going to show you what else I'm going to put on this dish. I've got some great herbs that I picked from my garden. I've got rosemary, I've got thyme, I've got Italian parsley, I've got sage, I've got marjoram. And I've chopped some of them up, and I'm going to use them as a garnish on the skin of the chicken. And also I've got wonderful fennel. Fennel is an amazing vegetable. This is what it looks like before it's chopped up. What I do is I take a bulb and I quarter it. And fennel is a delicious vegetable, and it goes great in like dishes like this, like a roast chicken or something, and has this wonderful, unique flavor to it. Also, this dish is a kind of a take, a variation on the theme of chicken with 40 cloves of garlic. It's a French dish that I cook sometimes. However, this particular time I'm not gonna use 40 cloves of garlic, as you can see, because I don't want that much garlic in it. So I got other stuff. I got shallots. And this is the shallot, what it looks like before it's cut up, and there it is. It's halved and the skin's taken off. And you leave the skin on the garlic because you do not, you're gonna use that for a special occasion. What you're gonna do is you're gonna squeeze the garlic out when it's all done and spread it on French bread. Oh man, on a baguette, it's just crazy good. All right, so I'm gonna get a nice little shot of it right here, and I will see you when I put this stuff in the chicken. Now, you can see I placed the vegetables and the herbs all around the chicken, and I've also crushed some fresh ground pepper, coarse ground pepper, on the chicken as well. And you pour a little bit of olive oil on the vegetables, the shallots and the fennel and the garlic, and I'm gonna put it in the oven. So this is what it looks like before. When it looks like after, it's just like something from the gods. I mean, come on, you're gonna so love this thing. So just stay with me. Also, I'm going to show you how to make some awesome fried potatoes. And I've saved some of the herbs that we're going to use, and we're going to put that on there. So I'm going to serve that alongside the chicken. So stay with me. It's going to be well worth it. And you're going to want to make this, believe me. All right. Okay, as promised, I'm going to show you how to make some herb roasted potatoes in my, which I'm making in my liquisette saucier. But you can use any pan. So what I've done is I put some olive oil in the pan, and I've cut some red potatoes in half. And I put one of the shallots that I had left over from the chicken in there. And also I sprinkled the rest of the herbs on top of the potatoes. So, and I put some salt and some crushed coarse grain pepper. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put them on the stove top. I'm gonna get them browned on there, and then I'm gonna put them in the oven with the chicken, beside the chicken. And when they come out, they're gonna be golden brown, and they're really good this way. They're really amazing, actually. All right, now I've taken the chicken out of the oven for a second here to baste it in the juices. And you can see it's been in there about an hour now. And I don't like to do this for very long, but I'm doing this strictly for the video, because I only take it out and do it and slam it back in there again because I want it to stay hot. So, does that not look nice? Okay, that's about half done. You can see all these shallots and fennel and everything roasting really nice. Beautiful. All right, I'm gonna put it back in. I gotta go, baby. Bye-bye. And this, my friends, is what it looks like. I just took it out of the oven, and I cooked it at 425 for about a little under an hour and a half. And but you want to, I have a meat thermometer, and I stick it in various parts of the chicken, like the thickest part of the thigh and the breast. You want it to be 165 degrees at least. It's a little bit over. That's okay. I'm gonna let it sit for a little bit and let the juices meld in here. I've basted it one more time, and then I'm gonna plate it and show you what it looks like. Does that not look good? Look at these perfectly roasted savory vegetables and garlic and the herbs and everything encrusted on there. It's just a delicious looking chicken. And there it is, my friends. Roast chicken a la Rivera. Or you could call it urban roast chicken. Or you could just call it roast chicken. Give you a better view of it right here. Does that not look delicious? You can see the roasted potatoes on there. And you can see the shallots and the fennel and everything else that I've got in there. And there's a little close-up of it. I'm going to be pairing this tonight with a nice Chablis. It's from William Fabre. It's French Chablis, which I like. It's got a very high minerality. It's very clean. Tastes really good with a good Montfrechet as well, but I don't have one of those tonight. So, there it is. Enjoy. All I can tell you is, I really wish you could be here to taste this amazing chicken with me. And it goes so well with this wine too. Oh my God, it's just absolutely delicious. The fennel. It's savory. It's an autumn dish, a winter dish. And it's magnificent. And see, the potatoes are really, really good too as well. I'm just gonna sit here and eat. Talk to you guys. Be sure to tune in to John Rivera Urban Life. Subscribe to me, because I got amazing recipes like this that are just, you know, they're real simple to make, no big deal, and delicious. And you'll love them. Thank you for watching, and have a wonderful evening. Salut. John Rivera, Urban Chicken, man-made, cat-approved. Hey, Benny, you like that?